Hello, for the Investing News Network, I'm Bryan Mc Govern with our monthly update video for February. One of the biggest stories in the Canadian cannabis market right now is the upcoming opening of the Ontario legal retail market. This is set to open in April. The province decided to prevent licensed producers from participating in this space and placed hard caps on how much LPs were allowed to be involved in it. But now, companies with backing from LPs or LPs themselves are finding ways into the Ontario retail market through new partnerships with winners of the Ontario lottery for the retail space. What this means is that thanks to these partnerships, these companies are now allowed to participate in the space and even help in the opening of these stores. Some of the confirmed deals so far have public cannabis retailers such as High Tide and Choom, which have investments from Aurora Cannabis participating in the space. Inner Spirit Holdings, a retailer that has a deal in place with New Strike Brands and LP for the setup of an owned shop. And Fire and Flower, another cannabis retailer which has secured two spots in the Ontario market. A Nova Cannabis store is also set to open in Ontario. This brand belongs to Alcanna, which has a public investment from Aurora Cannabis as well. This new strategy even includes the biggest name in the Canadian cannabis market, Canopy Growth. It was revealed that the company's brand, Tweed, is set up to open a store in Ontario as well, thanks to this one of these partnerships. The two deals for Fire and Flower were reported to be worth more than $1 million worth of stock for each one of them. Ultimately, it's up to the Alcohol and Gaming Commission of Ontario to take a closer look at these deals, review them, and see whether or not they will be going through. Brina Boonstra, Director of Quality and Regulatory Issues with Cannabis Compliance, told us that these deals were no secret. A lot of discussion about whether or not LPs would be buying their way into the Ontario retail market was an open discussion. As the pot stock market settles into 2019, INN asked a variety of experts to give their opinion on what will be the major trends for the investing year. And the major takeaway was multi-state operators in the U.S. No one but a portfolio manager with Purpose Investments told us that his firm has been looking at these companies for the past 5 or 6 months way more aggressively. Alan Brockstein, cannabis analyst with 420 Investor, told us that in 2019, he expects to see more listings come from these US companies rather than Canadian ones. You can check out our full story on INN and even see a list of some of the multi-state operators that the analysts agree will have a good year in 2019. Stay tuned to INN for more cannabis news and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn. See you next month.